Now let's be honest, finding software to restore your phone can be very, very challenging. You know, people, they see a phone and they fall in love with the phone and they are like, I'm gonna buy that phone. But when you buy a phone, there are several things that you should think of. You should think of, hey, is the bootloader locked? Can I ever unlock the bootloader whenever the company is not gonna update the phone anymore? Yes or no? If that is yes, then it's a good one. Two, are there any developers, independent developers around for whenever that phone's gonna be outdated so I can still use the phone? If that answer is yes, that's very good. Three, you're gonna ask yourself, the phone, is it durable? What can I do with it? Quality, etc. The parts, repair services and so. Can the phone shops repair these phones? If that is a yes, then in fact you're kinda good to go. These are some questions that you really should ask yourself. Now, you see me showing a whole lot of Samsung phones here on my channel because Samsung is a phone that many people buy and as well many people sell, and at a certain moment you can buy them really cheap, and then you know you buy some of these phones to then do some software project on them. In fact, it's an addiction because it's a hobby, because you keep buying. In fact, you're not buying to sell again, so you're not making any profit at the end. You know, the only thing that you're gonna keep as a reward will be the things that you learned while doing all these projects, you know. So sometimes you got to pay and spend money to learn. If you go to school, you need to buy books. You need to, these are most of the times even more expensive than these phones that I buy these days. So these are my study books. So I have many of these Samsung phones, as well have some other phones that I most of the times not even use anymore. I just have them because they are collector's item, and once in a while, especially for these kinds of people, you know, I make a video and show them, you know, how I still can use the device in 2020. But how to get firmware for your Samsung phone in a normal way? For instance, you know, sometimes you install some ROM and the ROM effect development is not really going too good yet for the phone, and then you want to go back to your stock ROM because on there you could at least do whatever you wanted to do. So how to get the firmware? Of course, you can go to Sam Mobile. We used to do that in the past, you know, and create the account, and then you can download. A whole lot of hassle, really. You must go make puzzles, and so if you're maybe 60 and older, then probably you will not even understand how to get through the process to create the account. So Sam Mobile. Then I made another one. What was it again? I made a video about them. Updato.com, Updato.com. But hey, these guys as well, they went commercial. You must first create account. Nonsense, rubbish. In fact, pimping, in fact, the software from Samsung, because that's just how it is. All right, they are as well paying hosting. No, maybe I'm saying it wrong. Anyway, they needed extra cash, so you must now as well become a member. And if you want fast downloads, then you must pay. If you want to download free, you can hit the download button and start downloading. So I was like, that is not good enough anymore for my people. You know, here on my channel, I like to show the very best websites out there where you can go to and download something without, you know, feeling messed up afterwards that you're waiting for 3-4 hours to download a file from 1.2 gigabyte. Come on guys, what is that? You know, most of the times you can as well look at androidfilehost.com, you know, just type the model of the phone, and sometimes you find guys that upload the actual firmware to that site. But this site is called samfw.com, and these guys really, I've been checking it out. I'm gonna show you a short, you know, little example of how you can download files up there. I saw download speeds up to 5 megabytes per second. I mean, like with these speeds are only, I find them on Mega Upload and on Google Drive. These are the only two places where I can find speeds like that for official firmware. So samfw.com is a nice site that I want to promote today, just because, you know, some of you might want to, you know, once in a while go back to the official firmware if you have a Samsung phone. I cannot talk for the other phones, because in fact I find out that these other phones, you go to the site and there is nothing there, you know, there is totally nothing there. Yeah, some of them they have a good service, but most of them, yeah, what can I say, you know, can you really go ahead and download the ROM? And yeah, most of them have these days locked bootloaders, crazy business, you know. Yeah, best thing to do is or buy a Samsung phone or buy a Google phone, really. Google phones, these are the best, because they keep getting the latest versions of the Google Android operating system, because Google will always push it to their own phones first. That is very normal. They create the operating system, so it must go to their phones first. In fact, I would let go everything to the Google phones, and all the other phones could go download gaps if you want to use the Google Play Store. No, just kidding, peeps. But yeah, all jokes on a little stick. I'm telling you, my friends, samfw.com is the site where you want to go to. And now I'm gonna show you some examples. And yeah, I'm sure that this video, yeah, it will lighten up your day if you've been looking for firmware to download and you've been still downloading from Sam Mobile. So there we are, my friends. What you're looking at is the site called samfw.com. Link will be in the description. Okay, so whenever you're gonna go to the site up here, you can type in your firmware. Let's say the i9300. I just want to go for some old phones. There, i9300. So why was it not seeing the Gyo? Let me see if it can find the Gyo. Oh, the Gyo firmware is not to be found. The i9000. Yeah, the 9000. There we go. Samsung Galaxy S. Not that I ever gonna change my Linux OS that is running on it now, but just for the video. Here you can see all the versions that you can download. 2.3.6. Okay, so you're just gonna click the link. You see here link, and then you click it, and then you wait a second, and then you go down here. Yeah, and then you can say, I'm not a robot. It's calling Heimdall. Check this, peeps. And then download on website, need big RAM. That means, yeah, I think machines with 2 GB and more should be able, or maybe 4 GB, will be easy downloading this. And here you can see the download rates, guys. Look at the download rates. You see what I'm saying? look at that. This is a file from 170 megabytes. It's only 170. That's very small. Firmware info. Oh, of course, it's probably packed. Let's see. Boom. And now you can save the file. You see that? Have you ever seen a ROM? Oh yeah, of course, this is for the i9000. At that time, these files were not so big. The S9, for instance, S9. Here, S9 Plus. That is a very big file. This one here, Android 10 Q. You see that? S9 got Android 10. Wondering if it's gonna get Android 11. So this is 4 GB. And the CSC is, yeah, you must download the right file for your, and then up here, I'm not a robot. This guy knows that, know immediately that I'm not a robot. This is not some scam website. And there you go, boom. This file will take about 14 minutes, 12 minutes to download. If you know any faster website where you can download firmware, then you must let me know. I think these guys, these are the bosses of the Samsung firmware. Even if you pay Sam Mobile, will not be able to give you these kinds of speeds. I'm gonna stop this, guys, because yeah. Otherwise, I'm gonna run out of space. I need my space for other things, you know. So yeah, that is it. Sam FW, guys. That is the website that you want to use, okay, and that you want to look into whenever you need any firmware for your Samsung phone or tablet. Well, did I say too much? These are good download speeds, good download rates. So go ahead, download your firmware, download it, guys, and put it on your, yeah, on your Google Drive, and share it from there with people, with your friends. So at a certain moment, we the users as well have a database with all these firmwares. You can upload it, for instance, to, let me think, to Google, of course. Mediafire could, but it's a little bit slow with downloading. Mega Upload is not my favorite choice, because most of the times you must then download the tool from them, and it's a whole hassle. Then you must go create the account. It's very annoying. It's great if we can download the files just like that from Mega, then everything is just fine. Then, you know, download speeds are fine. But the moment that you must go ahead and install that app, that you must install your browser, then it's getting annoying to me, and then I as well don't download the file anymore, or I go with the computer that has more cache memory available, so I can then still download it. So yeah, I meant to say archive, of course, the archive.org website. Up there we can as well find a whole lot of old firmware for our devices, for our Macs, old operating systems from Apple, we can find out there. I even saw old versions from Windows out there without license keys, of course. You will need that yourself. And all these kinds of, you know, firmware that can repair your phone back, you can find on all these sites. So I'm kind of getting the best sites together, and this the samfw.com website is at this moment, you know, March 2nd, 2020, the very best place where you can download your Samsung firmware for your Samsung phone or tablet. Well, ladies and gentlemen, that was it. I hope you enjoyed this video. I have some other tech videos coming up. Android 10 for several other devices that just came out. I of course must make these videos. I was a bit busy with my band, you know. Really, I was very tired this weekend. We had a very heavy weekend, and yeah, that's why today, first easy video, how to get your firmware, and a little talk, of course, and in the next video, these phones that will come up. I saw that NSSoon as well created a new Android 10 for the Samsung Galaxy S6, all models. Well, not all models, but the zero models, all the zero models are supported. So that's it. See you in the next video. My name is Puck. Thank you for watching. I hope you enjoyed this talk show. And then I see you in the next video again. That will be even more action and fun for you that have these devices as well. See you in that video. Until then, bye bye.